Hi everyone. Previously we had discussed about acute mountain sickness. We had a very detailed discussion about the symptoms, how to treat it, and even how to prevent acute mountain sickness. Today we're going to discuss something that is often considered the advanced stage of acute mountain sickness, HAPE and HACE. For that, I have Sandhya with me. She's a partner at Indiahikes and she's been trekking for over 15 years. In all the years of trekking, she's seen several cases of HAPE and HACE firsthand. She's helped treat them and also she's told people how to prevent it. So thank you, Sandhya, for being here.
Hi, Swati. Thank you for having me on the show.
Can you elaborate a little bit on HAPE and HACE? I've read that it's an advanced stage of acute mountain sickness and that it can be very serious. So can you tell me a bit about it?
So as you talked on your previous show, acute mountain sickness is when you climb up to a high altitude and your body is not able to cope up with it. Mm-hmm. It starts showing all sorts of symptoms and the only way to prevent it or get out of it is to descend. Now when you're at an altitude, and further more acute form of this is what is HAPE and HACE. HAPE is high altitude pulmonary edema and HACE is cerebral edema. And in both these cases, water or fluids get into your lungs in the case of pulmonary edema and brain in the case of cerebral edema. And it is really, really serious. It can be fatal. So it's very important that you act on these HAPE and HACE as soon as you see that it is showing signs and not wait any longer.
So I've heard that HAPE and HACE occurs only at altitudes over 16,000, 17,000 feet. Is that true?
Not really, not at all actually. So HAPE and HACE can occur at any altitude above 8,000-9,000 feet. People don't think that is a reality, but that is a reality. And at Indiahikes itself, we have had so many cases where people are hit by HAPE and HACE at altitudes like 10,000 feet, 11,000 feet, on treks like Kedarkanta, Harkidun, where you would think that, okay, they're very mid-altitude or lower-altitude treks. So not at all.
So can you elaborate a little bit on HAPE? What exactly is HAPE and how is it caused? What are the symptoms and how do you treat it also?
So HAPE or pulmonary edema is when water gets into your lungs. So basically what happens is when oxygen is less in the air, the blood vessels around your lungs start constricting and this increases your blood pressure, which in turn leads to water getting accumulated in your lungs. And the whole thing is a very vicious cycle where, okay, water gets into your lungs, oxygen further reduces in your blood, and then more water gets in. And if left untreated, the whole thing can actually spiral out and the person can die within a question of few hours.
How does this show up on a trekker? What are the symptoms of this?
We often see people who come to camps at 11,000-12,000 feet. Some of them are extremely exhausted by the time they come in. Maybe they come in an hour later than the entire group. And then even after coming in, they're extremely exhausted. They may be very exhausted even to go to a kitchen tent and get water or go to the toilet tent. Or even at rest, they're feeling breathless. Or even a very small activity can make them extremely breathless. So breathlessness is a very, very important sign that you have to watch out for. One more thing is coughing. People are absolutely fine at the lower camps, but when they come to the higher camp, they start coughing. Now, this is not normal. So you have to watch out on anybody who develops a cough at high altitude. By high altitude, I mean these 10,000, 11,000 feet. So don't give cough syrup and think that, okay, it's a random cough that is coming. No, it's not. Breathlessness and coughs are very, very important signs of HAPE. And you have to catch it at that stage. When you read books, you see that people develop pink frothy sputum or lips turn blue and stuff like that. These are extremely advanced stages and these advanced stages happen within 4-5 hours. So it's very important you track it at that initial stage of fatigue, breathlessness and coughs and not let it go beyond.
So Sandhya, this HAPE sounds quite scary. So how do you treat HAPE? I mean, you said it's going to climb onto you in very few hours. So how do you treat HAPE?
So treatment for HAPE especially is nothing but descent. So you have to catch it and descend. Now you may be at a high altitude and descent itself may take 7-8 hours. So what do you do in this case? If you leave it just like that, the person may worsen further and die. So what you do is you first go give him Diamox, because Diamox helps you acclimatize and that he must always be on Diamox. Dimox alone is not enough. So you give him a course of a tablet of something called as nifedipine. Now nifedipine helps him reduce his blood pressure. So because I told you, the blood pressure increases and the fluid gets in. When the blood pressure is reduced, this fluid accumulation also goes down. And this does give him a span of a few hours for him to escape. Oxygen is another important treatment that you give, because again the whole thing is caused by lack of oxygen. A flow of oxygen during this course of descent is very, very important. And by descent, you have to descend all the way to 7,000-8,000 feet where there are trees. It doesn't mean that if you're at 14, you descend to 12, you're okay. That is also not okay.
Okay, so what about HACE? Is it an advanced stage of HAPE or is it something completely different?
HAPE and HACE are two different things. One is the cerebral, another is the pulmonary thing. So HACE is when fluids accumulate in your brain. And what are its symptoms? A person who has HACE will generally have very severe headache, because it's something to do with your brain. And he also feels nauseatic, he may vomit. Now these are what he feels. For another person who's observing him, HACE often comes with this person may be behaving very illogically. He may be talking, you may ask him X and he may answer Y. Or he may not be able to do basic coordination activities, like basic what is 2 plus 2, he may not be able to say 4. Yeah, there is a total lack of coordination in the brain. He may be acting illogically. One simple test you can do to find out if he has HACE is ask him to walk heel to toe. Let us draw a straight line and ask him to walk on that straight line straight. Most probably then they won't be able to do that. So that's a very simple test on detecting HACE. And just like HAPE, HACE can turn fatal in just a few hours. And it's very important that you descend this person as soon as possible.
Okay, so what if you don't have enough time to descend immediately to, a tree line? What exactly do you do then?
Assume that there is generally not enough time. That's why you have to give this medicine called as Dexamethasone, which is a steroid. And this medicine buys you time to descend. It's kind of, you give it in intervals of every 4 to 6 hours, and it keeps you fine for those 4 to 6 hours, and you just have to get out. They don't solve the issue, they just buy you time to get out of there.
So Sandhya, I've read a lot that HAPE occurs more often than HACE. Is that true?
That is very, very true. So if we have seen that, not only we, it's generally seen that HAPE occurs about 70 to 80% times more than HACE. Okay. So on a trek, on a high altitude trek, be very, very watchful for HAPE. HACE also, but since HAPE is more common, it's not something that you can ignore.
Okay. And generally, are these two very common illnesses that you see at high altitude, as common as acute mountain sickness?
See, generally, whenever you go to a high altitude above 11, 12,000 feet, we see about 10% people suffer from AMS, some mild form of AMS. And out of this, about maybe 2-3% people get into the HAPE and HACE mode. So it's not something that you can ignore at all. And what generally happens is you may not suffer. You may have a fellow trekker who's suffering. So you must know how to recognize these symptoms of AMS, HAPE and HACE, and also know how to act on it, because you can save lives.
So Sandhya, do HAPE and HACE always occur as a later stage of AMS, or do they occur even by themselves? I mean, does AMS always accompany them?
Mostly yes. See, generally you don't get HAPE and HACE just like that overnight. You will have some symptom of AMS, like a headache or you're feeling dizzy or exhaustion. All these are common symptoms. And AMS is the first stage. Which later develop into this. But having said that, you can also have HAPE directly or HACE directly. It can happen in any order, but you must always be watchful for any of these symptoms.
So Sandhya, do HAPE and HACE only occur while ascending, or is it possible to get HAPE and HACE even while descending or during any time of the trek?
We have actually seen more cases of HAPE and HACE coming on the way down and not really at the highest camp. Now there's a reason behind this. The trekker might have got affected by mild symptoms of AMS while on the way up. And what he thinks is, the summit is just right here, let me do it. And anyway, I'm going to go down and I'll be better. The symptoms will just improve on the way down. But that's not the case. Down doesn't mean he's all the way down to tree line. So he would have gone to the higher summit and come back to the camp below at 3-4 in the evening. And that's where the danger lies. And that's where over the night his symptoms might deteriorate further and develop into HAPE or HACE. So don't be off your guard just because you have descended, and that is where you're more likely to get hit by HAPE or HACE.
Okay, well, yeah, that makes sense. So, Sandhya, I'm going to digress a little bit over here. Someone asked me this question. Many trekkers think they should drink alcohol at high altitude to keep themselves warm. So, is that advisable at all? Because I've heard that, it's quite evident that alcohol sort of accelerates HAPE and HACE or any altitude sickness. So, is that advisable at all?
Right, another very interesting question. A lot of people think that alcohol doesn't do any much harm and actually keeps them warm, and nothing can be more wrong than this. Alcohol actually aggravates AMS. What it does is it slows your respiration rate, and in turn your amount of oxygen available for you goes down, and you can have AMS setting onto you rapidly. We have seen so many cases of people taking alcohol at high altitude and then developing AMS rapidly.
So basically no alcohol on a high altitude trek.
That's right.
Okay. Thank you so much, Sandhya. That was very insightful. Today we learned a lot about HAPE and HACE, and in detail we learned how to treat it, how to prevent it, and I'm sure this will be very helpful for all trekkers. It's important to know all these things so that you can recognize the symptoms and nip it in the bud. So thank you so much for joining us. If you have any questions, you can tell me on trekwithswati@indiahikes.in, and I'll probably get Sandhya to answer them for us. Thank you so much.